Hello and welcome. My name is Jonathan Vita, and we're going to be discussing the Summa Theologiae by Thomas Aquinas, Question 2, Articles 1 through 3. An overview of what we're going to be covering in this portion of the Summa. First, is God's existence self-evident? That's one question we're going to be discussing. This is basically asking the question whether this is something that we just know intuitively, know instinctually, or something like that. If it's self-evident, it's available and known just by analysis or just thinking about it. Or is an argument for God's existence even possible? Is this the type of thing that an argument can prove? Lastly, we can talk about what Aquinas considers are some proofs that he thinks show that God exists. Namely, he gives 5 different ways he thinks this is provable. Now, Aquinas does not think that God's existence is self-evident to us. So if you think that God's existence, that he's real, is evident, self-evident, that it's known, that it's knowable just by thinking about it deeply, you might think that there's a way that you can just know this automatically, that you wouldn't even need a proof for God's existence. So if you think that we know God exists and it's self-evident that God exists, you might think that the knowledge of God is implanted or innate. And so it's evident because, the idea of God is placed in our minds, either directly by God or by instinct. That is, as you kind of grow up under normal conditions, normal people automatically believe that God exists. There are lots of different things that we automatically believe is true, like the whole is greater than the sum of its parts, or maybe that all triangles, all figures that have 3 angles, it's a closed figure, have 3 sides. Maybe there's just no way you could think otherwise. Maybe the knowledge of God is something like that. It's implanted or it's innate. We just grow up with this kind of knowledge. Normal people normally believe that God exists. Whether this is God places it in your mind or just by instinct, people just are caused to believe that God exists. And so if you think that you can know God that way, then God would be self-evident. Another way you might think that God is known in a self-evident kind of way is if you just understand what God is and work through the definition of God, you might just come up with the idea that God must be real. If you think about the kind of thing that God is, whether he's a necessary being or something than which none greater can be thought or some other definition, you just have to believe that God isn't contingent. God must exist. God will necessarily exist. Or you might think, and this is maybe a little stranger of an idea, you might think that if God doesn't exist, then all knowledge about the world, all things that are true, are just cease to exist. You wouldn't have an anchor for anything to be true. You wouldn't have an anchor for any knowledge. And so since you do know things, and since there are things that are true, then there has to be something that's absolutely true, like God. So God is self-evident because there has to be something that's absolutely true. Now, Aquinas' answer is, first, it's not incoherent to think of God not existing. That is, we can make sense of the claim God doesn't exist. We know what that would mean if it were true. And if it's not incoherent to think of God not existing, then it's not obvious that he does exist. If it's not obvious that God does exist, then it's not self-evident to us that God exists. So it's not incoherent to think that God doesn't exist. It makes sense if somebody said God doesn't exist. We understand what that means if somebody makes that claim. So he doesn't think it's self-evident, but he has a way to try to answer some of these concerns. First of all, the claim God exists, it is self-evident if we think about this. It's self-evident to God. God knows that God exists, and there's no way that God can doubt that he exists. But God knows himself thoroughly. God knows the kind of thing that God is. God knows himself. But we don't necessarily know. We don't know God's essence. So, as a reply to the first one, knowledge of God is implanted or innate, he does want to say, okay, it's natural to believe God exists, but there's not enough information from that instinctual knowledge for you to actually conclude that it's the kind of God that we would attach to any kind of religion, or that this would be the kind of God that is the creator of the universe. So even if it is natural to believe God exists, it doesn't provide enough information for the rest of the kinds of arguments that we would want to talk about this being the true God or something like that, or this is the God of the religions. So it gives too little of information. It's too sparse. Our natural knowledge of God is just, it's too weak. So it doesn't maybe count for knowledge. It might just count for opinion. But it isn't self-evident, even if it's self-evident to God that God exists, it isn't self-evident to us what is the right definition for God. So if you think God can be known by definition, you got to pick the right definition. And Aquinas doesn't think it's obvious which definition is the right definition for God, whether it's necessary being or the being than which none greater can be thought, or something than which none greater can be conceived, or something like that, whether it's from Anselm's ontological argument or somewhere else, it isn't obvious which definition is the best one. So even if a definition does imply that that being exists, it isn't obvious that the definition actually holds for the God that we're trying to talk about. So it isn't self-evident which definition is the right one. It seems like it could be arbitrary which definition you pick. Likewise, you might even say that the definition of God requires that we understand the kind of thing that God is in a way that we know God's essence. But we don't have access to that. As he's already said, we don't know God's essence. God knows God's essence. God knows the kind of thing that God is. Lastly, for the third concern, you might say, like, without God, nothing is true, nothing can be true. Now, Aquinas wants to say some things are true, and there is something that's absolutely true, as he's willing to go straightforwardly with the Bible and say, like, that Jesus is the truth and things like that. But he can set all of that aside for now. He can just say, just because some things are true doesn't automatically mean that without God, nothing can be true. There could be some other thing that's absolutely true, even if it isn't God. So it's, strictly speaking, the third concern, it doesn't follow. It doesn't follow. It's not a good argument. It's not a good concern.